tango dancers around the globe. Michael, I've got an Atochi here with you to teach you some leader's technique. Of course, some of the technique is equally important for leaders and for the followers, but I will orient this class mostly towards those of you who lead. Now, the first thing I would like to talk about is the positioning of the body. I will stand absolutely straight and neutral, no effort made in my body right now. And what I'm going to do is breathe in from my stomach a little bit to lift up my rib cage and my diaphragm slightly. Now, make sure that the tension doesn't go into your shoulders. So I will do a very natural breathing movement. So I feel that my chest expanded a little bit, but my shoulders are relaxed. And I always propose to exercise either in the position of the leader's embrace, where both of your elbows are slightly in front of your body, or make a circular position and try not to modify it. Once you take the position of the embrace, try this idea with me. Change your weight to the left foot and to the right foot. Left and right, minimizing the movement of your axis, as well as minimizing the movement of your feet. Try to really keep your heels together and just do a tiny bit of movement necessary to shift your weight to the right foot, lift your left, do the little test, close your heels, change weight, release the weight, because if you cannot stand on one foot, you cannot turn later on. Let's talk a little bit about initiating the tango walk. There are so many ideas and techniques floating around. I will just give you the most essential part in which I personally believe and I use in my own dance. Once you position yourself straight with a slightly uplifted rib cage, try to begin the movement forward by moving your pelvis over the ball of the foot. Now notice, when this movement happens, I take my entire body with me. Another way to look at this, I imagine that my tailbone and my solar plexus are moving forward as one unit, as well as returning back. Once you try this movement without leaning forward and without pushing your hips too far ahead of your body, you will feel that the pressure over the ball of the foot is now slightly increased, and you will also feel that your ankle is starting to work a little bit more to maintain the balance. Now, do this test a few times, and once you feel comfortable and fully in control, release your free leg to take a walk. Take a natural walk forward, stop, and stop. Take the position of the embrace. Move slightly forward from your pelvis, release your free leg, and take a few slow, natural steps. Once again, change weight. You can try walking from the left or from your right foot. Move your pelvis slightly forward, release the leg, take a few steps. Sometimes I like to elongate my step to change the feel of the walk as well as to change the musicality. For that, we will need the second most essential technique for tango walking. Lowering your center, your body, slightly over your standing knee. Now, this is an important movement because if I intend a slower walk forward, lowering my knee If I intend a slower walk forward, lowering a little bit will help me to stay balanced longer over my foot before I transfer the weight. For example, prepare, move, once again, and move. You can see two things are happening along with this walk. First, when I lower, my base begins the motion forward. I am not doing it in a purely vertical way. I am already combining the motion forward from my pelvis with a slight motion downwards. And second thing, you will see that I will project my legs slightly further ahead of my body, and now I will need to push a little bit stronger from my standing leg to be able to complete the walk. Once again, I prepare the movement, project my leg, give it a good push. I will now demonstrate El Gato style with the music. Make sure you practice this type of walking extremely slowly so you can really feel where is the control point in transferring the weight. We want to avoid sudden change of weight. I would say that I spend a little bit more time between my feet when I'm walking slower and delay the transfer of my body weight. Let's now talk about pivots, because a large portion of Argentine tango is built around turning, especially for the type of the movement that we call giro or molinete, when the leader is the center of the turn. Now, of course, you can keep your footwork very, very simple, down to the minimum, and dance milonguero style, just making sure that you are taking care of your partner. This class is not so much about teaching you how to lead. This class is more about teaching you how to dance and giving you some tips which can give you a better balance or better understanding of your own body and the movement in tango. So I'm going to focus on the movements. When the man stays a little bit more vertical over his axis, which allows him to pivot, and later on we can examine how this works in a partnership. First tip. Whenever I'm working with pivots, I will combine slight flexion of my knee with pushing my heels off the ground a little bit. This movement will allow you to engage your ankles in the process of the pivoting. Then I can test if this idea works by keeping all my weight on the left foot or keeping all my weight over the right foot. And as you can see, I am creating the pivot from my lower body, not from the upper body. Of course, generally speaking, the upper body begins the movement of the rotation. But if you really want to exercise the pivot, you should think of isolating your lower body from your upper body and making a small pivot on either foot without moving your torso. Take this simple exercise that will help you later on to draw a figure that we call lapis. I put all my weight over the right foot, take the position of my embrace, my shoulders slightly rounded, flex my right knee a little bit, and release the left foot for drawing. Right now, as you can see, my right heel is planted on the ground, so I am not pivoting. Now I will add slow turning or pivoting over my right foot. Left foot is drawing, the turn is happening to the left. And if I change my weight to the other leg, flex, draw, begin turning. As you can see, every time I pivot, I slightly release the heel of my standing leg off the ground without modifying my posture. This is really the secret for pivoting in Argentine tango. I have two secrets. One is what I just explained to you, and the second, I have tiny little wheels in a very special shoe in the ball of the foot, which help me to turn for a very, very, very long time without falling. Let's see how this works with the music. About pivots that are essential, for example, a pivot that serves the change of direction in a forward ocho. Now, in the previous exercise, you saw my body is turning as one block. I did not really use too much of my torso to generate the pivot. That is because we already discussed that I can use my lower body to turn. However, if you're dancing a typical forward ocho, the situation will change because in the moment of coordinating the walk, my upper body will already begin the movement of the change of direction. For example, if I'm walking forward with my left foot, my upper body will start turning to the left to say hello to you in the moment of the weight transfer. By the time I have arrived on my foot, you will see that I am facing you. Now, this is the limit of my torsion. I cannot go more to the left with my upper body, so all I have to do now is bring my hips around to change the direction and to walk in the opposite direction. Let's see how it works if I combine a few steps together. Walking with my right foot, turning torso to the right. I have arrived on my foot, and now I will use the technique of the pivot to bring my hips around. Very important though, when I turn my hips to the right, I did not allow my torso to turn away from you. I am watching you because you are watching me all the time. Step with the left, initiate the movement, continue the movement. Step with the right, initiate the movement, continue the movement. Because I'm already facing you, there's very little motion that I can do towards the camera right now. I have very little motion. And most of the movement that you will see is happening in my hips. So it doesn't really look like I'm moving my torso a lot when I'm dancing a forward ocho. I'll show you now the movement from a different angle so you can understand it a little bit better. Walking with the right foot, turning to the right. Arrive on the foot, complete the pivot, close your feet together. Left foot, pivot, right foot, pivot, left foot, pivot, right foot, pivot. What's next? If I'm really comfortable over the foot and I feel that I have fully arrived on my foot, I will now extend the pivot and turn 180 degrees to work with a change of direction. For example, I'm facing the camera. Next step, I will turn more than usual. And now I am backing the camera. Now I will turn to face the camera again. In a way, what I'm doing is extending my pivot. The energy that I have created, the torsion between my upper body and my lower body, will give me enough energy to continue pivoting as long as you remember that your heel must not block the movement. if you are trapped in your house and exercising quarantine, you may not have a partner next to you available to practice. Well, what can we do? We can use some props. One of my favorite partners, when I don't have anyone to practice with, is the rotating chair. Why is this chair such an important part of my tango education? Because I found out that if I'm exercising a pattern of the heel, front step, open step, back step, open step, the typical exercise that your tango teacher showed you, holding the chair with both arms helps me to remember to always face the center of the turn. For example, if I put both of my arms on the chair and I take a front step with my left foot, you can see that I'm not simply walking towards you, but I'm actually turning the chair in the very moment of walking. And if I continue the movement, I will take care of the rotation of the chair on every step. There will be not a moment where I will dance and not turn the chair with me. That creates an excellent circularity in your motion. If you are a lady watching this, it could be beneficial for the heroes that you dance with your partner to create the circularity of the movement. If you are a leader, it helps you to exercise the position of your front ocho as well as the pivot into the back ocho that later will become your back saccada. And so let's take a look how this works in the music. This is my next prop. I would like to show you how to use a jacket to work on your isolation or on a contraposition. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to take the jacket off, put it in front of me so my elbows stay rounded, and I'm going to move my torso to my right and to the left from my hips. As you can see, there is no movement in my lower body. So this reminds me of a good old isolation, contraposition, disassociation, all those words that your teacher used when he or she were explaining a concept of lower body and upper body not moving together in tango. Now, let's make a little bit of a fancier move, because some of you out there are a little more advanced and you actually asked me on Instagram and on Facebook to show the more complex variations of the turn for the leader in the heel. For example, you can play with the idea of lápiz en aguja or lápiz en enrosque. I'm going to offer this one simple but not easy exercise for you. Now I will position my jacket to the right of my hips, put my weight on the right foot, and together with a movement of my left foot, drawing a circle, I will move the jacket to the left side of my body. So once again, I start with the jacket to my right, weight on my right foot, and coordinate the movement of the torso and the lower body. The most essential thing here is, when this movement happens, please do not allow any turn of your base. There is no pivot happening in that moment, and this is probably the biggest secret of all I paid 80 pesos 10 years ago for that secret. Now, let's see how it works in continuity. Lápiz. Move your jacket to the left. When you feel you reach the limit of your torsion, allow the pivot to happen on your right foot and bring your left foot over your right foot. The same way that ladies are dancing the basic cross. Take a look at this. Lats, torso, limit, turn your hips. Continue in the same way. Lápiz with the torso, bring your feet together, pivot on your standing foot, bring your left foot in contact with your right foot. There are many variations how you can bring your feet together, from more fancy to more simple ones. To keep things simple, I am going to keep my feet flat on the ground without lifting the heel of my free leg. Thank you very much for watching these technical videos. We have received a lot of requests to focus more on the solo technique for both leaders and followers, because we don't always have a partner to practice with during these difficult times. We hope that your feet are planted firm on the ground so you can do your pivots and your spirits are soaring high. Till the next video, please follow us on Facebook group. The link is down below, as well as our YouTube channel. And if you feel like contributing, there is a PayPal button on the official website, theartoftango.club/videos, where you can see the full collection of our teaching free online videos.